pigs and cocktails, singing song, drinking and dancing all night long. Whiskey and tequila, titties and beer, fun never ends, we're open all year. And if you want to be a YouTube star, come in and have a seat at Captain John's Bar. Bar's open, boys! Yee-haw!
Hello there! Bubba Bill coming at you one more time. I'm going to make a specialty dish for you. One of my special dishes, anyway. I'm going to make Bubba Bill's seafood salad. You want to talk about good? But, as always, ladies and gentlemen, the first thing you gotta do is get yourself a cold beer. You can't cook without a cold beer. But, anyway. Woo! Ain't that good? Well, my specialty seafood chowder, I gather all the stuff up my fishing. You got lobster, you got your clams and your quahogs, fresh codfish, you name it, I slide her in there. But when you take your main lobster, there's all them people out there says they're suffering when you put them right in that boiling water. I don't think they suffer too much, but just for the interest of this video, we're going to have to put them out of their misery a little easier, a little quicker. So, this is where I rely on old Betsy here. We'll tighten them up in a hurry. Wait a minute. This is the most humane way I can think of to kill a lobster. So, probably most people go a little further out of the house, but not old Bubba Bill. Yeah, he won't be moving.
Ha ha, I got him.
Come on, dog, go get him. Come on.
Good boy.
Now, once you've killed all your lobsters and the dog brought them all back to you, you want to take them bands off because that'll make that rubber tape. You don't want that. No, you don't want it. And you want to get yourself a pot. You put in about an inch or two of water, salt it, put in the beer, and you boil them up just about 15 minutes. I think the dog brought them all back. Dog, there we go, little one. Now it's going to take a while to do them lobsters because they got cooked and they got the cool and all that stuff. You might as well just start putting the beer right to you. That's what I do. Or I could be doing potatoes. You got to cut potatoes. You got to take your potatoes and you got to cut them up in little half inch, three quarter inch chunks. Got to have potatoes in there. Woo.
You can drink beer while you're peeling potatoes, if anybody can.
Now, once you've got most of the ingredients all manufactured, take your taters that you've got to cut up there. You dump them right in your pot. Like that. Then you just put a little bit of water, just like that right there, to cover your taters. Your lobster's all cooked anyway, and your clams are all cooked. So, only thing you've got really cooked is your taters and your fish. So we'll start that boiling right there. You want to get them taters so they're done, but firm. Good and firm, you know. I usually take and grind my clams right up, you know, so the flavor goes all through the stuff right there. So we got our onion and our garlic. We're going to add a little hot sauce. Wait till these get done right here. Time to have a cold beer. You take and dump your onions right in with your potatoes while them are cooking. And put your garlic right in there with it. And then you take your fish once your taters get done, you dump your fish right in there. That'll cook, fall right back. Once your fish is cooked, then you want to put a couple drops of hot sauce right in there. Oh yeah. Give it a little thing, not too much now. When you pick out your lobster now, when you break your claws, all your tamale and stuff, you want to put that right in with your juice in there. That'll give it some good flavor. You want to take all that tamale and all that stuff, you want to dump it right in there. Boy, that's good flavor. All the juice out of your claws and all good stuff. We're happy to flavor in your lobster. You can dump your chopped clams right in there. Boy. Get all that good stuff in there. Give that a stir. Oh yeah. What I'm talking about. Put that off to the side right there. Let that settle in good shape. Now we get to saute our lobster. Now you gotta get yourself a pan. This is where the trick comes in. You take about a half a stick of butter. You melt that up good shape. You wanna get a plastic spoon out of you when you put your pan in. Let that melt in good shape. Good time to have a cold beer. Jesus, ain't that good. You get that butter melting in there and you dump your lobster right in there. You saute that a little bit till you get that. You keep tilting your pan, you'll get a little bit of orange color in there. That's what makes your stew look like this. A lot of people don't know that stuff, but you get a cook like me, Bubba Bill, you got something. I know I probably told you this before, but this kick in your crack around the dirt a little bit. Oh yeah. That's looking good. Like I said, you keep tilting that up, you'll get this orange color when your butter keeps flowing down on the one side. That's when you know you got it good. Yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. She come and tell. That old Wakey 420 is supposed to come over. Maybe he wants to get his lips on the pile of this stuff. Oh yeah. He's going right now. Close enough for the kicks I've been dating. Over. You dump all that lobster right in there. Yeah. Bet you pay a dollar for that if you got it in the restaurant. You give that a stir. Yeah. had some fresh peppercorns in there. Yeah. A little bit of salt. You take your evaporated milk, because you left your water in there. You take a couple cans of evaporated milk, throw that right in there. Don't take it good now. Pour that right in there, honey. Give her a stir, see what that looks like. Shot in there. I ain't doing that again. Well, yeah, she's done. Right there. Look at that. My goodness. Seafood chowder. Like I said before, does it get any better than that? Bubba Bill! Woohoo!